Hello everyone, it's SpawnPoint and welcome back to another video. So this is the 77-inch C1 LG's 2021 OLED, and this is the 75-inch QNED99 LG's 2021 MiniLED TV. But which is better? With so many different TVs to choose from, how do you know which is best for you? And what are the real pros and cons of an OLED or a QNED? Well, today I'm going to compare these two screens side by side. I'll show the same content on both using this 4K HDR splitter to make it as fair as possible. We'll look at picture quality, motion handling, gaming, viewing angles, reflections, HDR and SDR content. So whether you're looking for one of these TVs for watching movies or gaming with the PlayStation 5 or Xbox Series X, I will cover it all. Everything is linked in the description, and if you haven't already, please hit that like button as it really helps me out. Let's start with the main differences between these two TVs. The TV on the left is the QNED, which is an 8K LCD TV. It's actually part of LG's new mini-LED range. Each mini-LED forms part of a zone which controls the pixels that you see. It turns them on and off as required. It's a combination of LG's nanocell and quantum dot technology. As these pixels are grouped together in a kind of a zone, it's not possible to completely turn each pixel off. Now this means, something that we'll see later, that the blacks aren't great. The TV on the right is the 4K OLED. Now there's no backlight here like we see with a QNED, as each individual pixel is self-lit. This means that instead of having a zone or a cluster of pixels being dimmed and lit together, they are 100% self-controlled. There are literally millions of pixels all able to power on and off, which leads to deeper blacks overall. So those are the differences, but what are the similarities between the two? Well, they are both 2021 models, similar size, have HDMI 2.1 support, WebOS and LG's new game optimizer mode. They both have the same remote control, or the magic remote, same buttons and same magic wand features. Taking a look at the UI and the apps, well, they both have the new 2021 WebOS features, so the full home screen display and all of your available apps. Right, let's take a look at how both of these TVs handle 4K and HDR content. These will be for your movies and your TV shows. Now I mainly watch Netflix, Disney Plus and Prime, all of which support 4K, so this should give a good example of the picture quality. Now when I did the QNED videos a few weeks back, I talked about how good the picture quality was. It really is a great TV. But from my testing over the last week or so, especially when having them side by side, the OLED just has a better overall picture quality. It's almost looked better in every single test. The actual picture of the TV, the sharpness, the detail, even the colours are so much punchier on the OLED. It makes the QNED look a little bit washed out, and the contrast is nowhere near as good. If you look here for example, where I've got the PlayStation 5 dashboard, you can see the difference in the picture quality. But the contrast goes hand in hand with black levels. So when you're watching any dark scenes on these TVs, you want the blacks to be as black or as dark as possible. You don't want them to be grey or cloudy looking. And this is where the OLED is better once again. Remember that the OLED's pixels are self-lit, while the QNED's pixels are grouped together in zones using mini-LEDs. In these dark areas, you can see that the OLED is perfect at showing shadows and contrast. Whereas the QNED, well, that struggles to show the same level of control. Now this might not be a huge issue for most, and when I was only using the QNED, I didn't really notice. It is fantastic at controlling the zones using the full array local dimming, but it's only when comparing them side by side that I've really noticed it. I think it's safe to say that during the day, both of these TVs look great. Even with the contrast differences of the QNED, it still has a fantastic picture. However, during the evenings or at night when you've got the lights off, that's when you really notice the difference. The OLED looks even sharper and a lot more vibrant, whereas the QNED seems to emphasize the LED backlight and the black level issues. Basically, any image on screen that shows a dark area or shadows, you can very clearly see it's a kind of more of a grey than a black. Now looking at the brightness between the two TVs, it's difficult to capture this, but the QNED is definitely brighter than the OLED. I've tried to match the brightness between the two TVs to make it easier to record and to watch back. However, if I max them both out to 100%, the QNED would be so much brighter. For me, that's not really an issue as the room is pretty dark and the TV is not opposite a window. But if you were placing the TV in a bright room, say a conservatory or near some windows, the QNED would definitely be the better choice for maximum brightness. With the current QNED, QLED and OLEDs available, it's well known that OLEDs, generally speaking, don't get as bright as the others. Now, if you're using either of these TVs for gaming, you'll want to know how good the input lag is and what the gaming features are. Fortunately, both of them have a very low input lag, so gaming is not an issue. And generally speaking, OLEDs are decent anyway, and any LCD TV that has a game mode will do a great job too. The C1 OLED can get as low as 5.2 milliseconds, whereas the QNED is at around 6.2. That's absolutely rapid. That's faster than most monitors that aren't gaming focused. Both of these will make a great gaming TV, which if you follow me already, you know that I game on my TVs for both the PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series X. Everything I've played on these two, whether it's been Call of Duty, Spider-Man, Kena, has had no issues. Now, I'm not sure if anybody picked up Kena a few weeks ago, but it's a nice and easy and fun game to play. Plus, it looks awesome on these TVs. Now, as both of these are the 2021 models, they come with LG's new Game Optimizer mode. This new overlay shows you some extra and easy to access settings that you can change. These don't boost performance at all, but you can control things like shadows and highlights along with picture profiles. One thing to note though is the C1 supports VRR, AMD FreeSync and G-Sync, along with HDMI 2.1 for 4K at 120Hz. The QNED also supports HDMI 2.1 with 4K at 120Hz. However, it does not support VRR, AMD FreeSync or G-Sync. This is a real shame for a TV that does support the game optimized mode, especially for a 2021 TV costing as much as it does. So both of these TVs can upscale content to 4K. In fact, the QNED can actually upscale to 8K. So with that in mind, you'd expect the QNED on the left to look far superior to the OLED on the right. And here they are, I'm splitting the same picture to both screens, where the QNED should definitely look better. But I'm not seeing any difference between the two in terms of resolution improvement, which shows that unless you're watching native 8K content, the QNED isn't really adding a huge leap in quality. Viewing angles are one of the biggest differences between these TVs. So when you watch either of them straight on, they look great. But as soon as you want to move or start to move off center, this is where you really notice the difference in both the picture quality and the contrast. So looking at the OLED first, if I start from the front and I start to move around the screen, you can see the picture looks very similar throughout that motion. Same quality, same contrast, and the same colors. Other than any reflections, you don't really lose any clarity in the picture at all. Now this is pretty extreme, you're obviously not going to sit at this angle from the TV, but it just shows how good the quality still is. Now taking a look at the QNED, so starting at the front, it looks great, and as we move around to the side, you can immediately see how the picture starts to lose its contrast and the colours. The picture actually starts to look quite bright as you start to see the LED backlights working behind. Now this is fine if you're watching it straight on, but as soon as you're sat to the side of the screen, maybe not to this extreme, you're going to see a difference in image than elsewhere. I'm not sure if this will be an issue for most people, but it's definitely something worth mentioning. So burn-in is one of the biggest talked about points of OLED. It's a comment I regularly get on my videos, so it's definitely worth mentioning today. So burn-in is where you get image retention on screen. It's usually where you've had, say, a logo on the screen for a long period of time or heads-up display from gaming. But for me personally, it's not an issue that I've ever had. Yes, I might swap my TVs out once a year, but I've still got my 3-year-old OLED up in the bedroom showing no signs of burn-in. I'm not saying it's not real, as there's plenty of reports out there, but it's never stopped me from playing games or using it for long periods of time. QNEDs on the other hand, where they have no such problem. So if you wanted a risk-free gaming TV, maybe QNED is the answer. But for me, having used 4 different OLEDs over the last few years, I would still buy another one. We've already talked about viewing angles, so let's have a look at reflections of these two TVs. So OLEDs generally speaking have a glossy screen, and although it's tinted, it's still very reflective. This means that if you're viewing the TV in a well-lit room or near some windows, you're going to see everything in it. So I have lights behind my TV and a window to the side, so straight on is not an issue. But once you move around, you can see the windows and any lights that I have on in the room. The QNEDs and LCD TVs in general, well, they have a matte or an anti-reflective screen, which makes them ideal for brighter rooms or near windows. You can see here that there's still a little bit of a reflection with this TV, but it's not as mirror-like as the OLED. So if you've got a dark room, like myself, the OLED will be absolutely fine. But if you've got a bright room or you want to use it in a conservatory, for example, the QNED is probably the better choice. If you're not using a soundbar or external speakers, you might be interested in knowing what the speakers sound like. Well, the QNED has a 60W 4.2 down-firing speaker setup, and they support Dolby Atmos. Whereas the C1 has a 40W 2.2 down-firing speaker setup, which also supports Dolby Atmos. The C1 does change to front-firing if you use the stand instead. But take a listen to this.
I mean, that's why I brought her.
And I'll tell you what, the QNED sounds so much better than the C1. But that's no surprise with the extra channels and the extra power. But as I've said before in other videos, I would always go for external speakers over TV speakers if you can. When it comes to the design and the overall look of these TVs, they are different. So while the OLED has an extremely thin frame at the top, it's got a bulkier bottom where it houses all the controls. Whereas the QNED, on the other hand, has an overall thinner profile from top to bottom. So if you were wall mounting these TVs and you wanted them to be as flat to the wall as possible, the QNED is a lot thinner overall. Plus it has these mounting brackets built into the TV to allow for an even flusher fit. saying that if you wanted the OLED and you wanted that to be as flush, you'd be better off looking at the G series. When you look at the branding of the two TVs, well, on the QNED, you've got the branding on the TV itself, while on the OLED, it's on the stand. Both of these stands have cable management built into the back, so you are able to hide those cables out of sight. So you can see the difference between the two stands here. The QNED has a traditional kind of monitor-looking stand, whereas the OLED has this brushed metal plate. Overall, I do prefer the look of the OLED stand, but if you're wall mounting it, it makes no difference. Both TVs come with the same ports, so that's four HDMI 2.1 ports, Ethernet, USBs, headphone out and optical. But the QNED actually has a better design and placing of these. I like the fact that the ports will mean the cables won't stick out towards the wall. So again, if you are wall mounting it, you haven't got that to worry about. Now, although these TVs are very similar in specs, well, the QNED does offer 8K capabilities. However, none of the examples or tests I've shown today really showed this off. But let me talk about the prices. So they are both on sale at most retailers at the moment, but I'll be using LG's website to show the RRP and the current prices. Now here in the UK, the QNED was £6,000 at launch, while the C1 was just £4,000, but they are now £4,500 and £3,500. The only reason the QNED is more expensive here is because it offers 8K. The 4K version is a lot cheaper. In fact, what the 4K model lacks in resolution, it makes up for with VRR. And if you were even considering buying the QNED99, I would probably go for the QNED91 instead. Right, so we've talked about picture quality, brightness, blacks, viewing angles, gaming, and reflections. But which is right for you? Or which is the best suited for your needs? So if I had to simplify it, I would say the QNED is ideal for brighter rooms, maybe with a lot of ambient light or near a window. The increased brightness of the TV will definitely help you out. Also, if you're worried about burn-in from, say, gaming, well, the QNED will give you peace of mind. But with that comes some slight viewing angle issues and the compromised black levels. And if you watch a lot of TV at night, you're going to see some grey shadows and the backlight issues. On the other hand, you've got an OLED which offers better input lag, better picture quality and incredible blacks. Plus, if you're watching it off-center, well, the viewing angles are awesome. But if your room is really bright or it's opposite a window, you might see a lot of reflections. So the ultimate question is, which is better? Which would I recommend buying now that I've compared the two side by side and tested out as much content as possible? The short answer is, I would go for the C1. It's better and it's cheaper, but even if the QNED was cheaper, like the 4K model, for me there's no reason I would pick the QNED over an OLED. Even with those pros and cons, the OLED just provides an overall better picture quality. So that's my choice, is the LG C1 OLED over the QNED99. Are you surprised? And which TV would you go for? Well, you've made it to the end of today's video, so thank you for watching. If you drop a QNED versus OLED in the comments, I will give you a thumbs up as I know you're still here. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel and turn notifications on so you don't miss my next upload. You can also follow me over on Instagram and Twitter. Until next time.